Oh, man. You made friends with him. See, friendship is the booze they feed you. Is they want you to get drunk and feeling like you belong.
Well, it was fun.
Because they make you feel cool. And hey, I met you. You are not cool.
I know. Even when I thought I was, I knew I wasn't.
Right, because we are uncool. Now, while women will always be a problem for guys like us, most of the great art in the world is about that very problem. Good-looking people, they got no spine. Their art never lasts. Then they get the girls, but we're smarter.
Yeah, I can really see that now.
Yeah, because great art is about, you know, guilt and longing and, you know, love disguises sex and sex disguises love. Hey, let's face it. Yeah, you got a big head start.
I'm glad you were home.
I'm always home. I'm uncool.
Me too.
You're doing great. Yeah. The only true currency in this bankrupt world is what you share with someone else when you're uncool. Listen, my advice to you, and I know you think these guys are your friends, if you want to be a true friend to them, be honest and unmerciful.
Welcome to the William Barron Show.
It's very melancholy.
It was Philip Seymour Hoffman in a nutshell, the actor that he is.
Like, of all the clips you could have picked, that one?
That's one of my favorite characters that he played.
All right.
Not one for celebrating life, are you?
No. Not at all.
No, but I mean,
when
Philip Seymour Hoffman talked, and I don't claim to be like this know-it-all Hoffman guy, but the roles that I have seen him play in have been just amazing. And when he is on the screen, like, you pay attention, or I pay attention to almost everything that he says.
Yeah.
Everything that he says, because he says it in such a way that I don't know of another actor that does it like he does. And when it came across my Facebook feed that he overdosed, I mean, no big shocker. I mean, that's how half of Hollywood dies. But yeah. It made me sad for like the whole day. Like, I couldn't get over it. It was Super Bowl Sunday, and it was just like, what the fuck?
Someone told me at halftime,
Rusty from fucking Twister is dead.
Like,
you gotta be kidding me.
I'm watching the halftime show, enjoying my balls off. I'm like, this is great entertainment.
It was a good halftime show.
I'm loving this.
Congratulations, Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Someone leans over and goes, hey, man, did you hear?
I'm pretending you were playing your instruments.
Right.
Did you hear Philip Seymour Hoffman died? And I go, what?
Right.
And he was like, I thought the guy was waiting for the punchline, because in my circle of friends, people try that all the time. Like, they try to start a rumor that someone famous died.
Oh, really?
To be the one that broke it on Twitter or Facebook.
TMZ.
I don't know. Just a joke. You know, it's a joke. Like, now all of a sudden David Alan Grier has to go make a public appearance. Like, I'm not dead, motherfucker. So I just thought he was joking.
Yeah.
And then he was like, yeah, man.
Dead. And it's sad. I asked you guys to, like, think of Philip Seymour Hoffman. I didn't even know that he was in The Big Lebowski.
Mm-hmm. Oh, come on.
I didn't.
That's because you don't like that movie.
I don't like that movie.
He's in Boogie Nights, too.
In Boogie Nights, yeah. I haven't seen that movie.
Yeah, well, you should have played that clip where he
awkwardly
hits on Mark Wahlberg.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, maybe that would be the segment.
Way more uplifting. I liked him in Twister.
That was my introduction to him, for sure.
Breakthrough role.
I liked him in Big Lebowski. That was so good.
Hilarious in Twister.
And Moneyball, he was awesome.
that was my impression of him from The Big Lebowski. Because the dude is leaving the premises.
The dude.
And as he's walking by, there's Tara Reid. And she's...
Tara Reid.
She's
Why can't she overdose?
She's painting her toenails.
William.
Seriously.
Oh, my.
And she says... and the dude's looking at her, and she's like, hey... I'll suck your dick for $100.
Thousand. It was a thousand.
No, it was $100.
It was $1,000. Because I was like, dude doesn't have $1,000 at the ATM.
She said it's...
Is he in his bathrobe leaving the bowling alley?
She said it's an extra $1,000 if he watches.
No, it's 1,000. She said 1,000. She said 100. She
whatever. Cheap. I can't understand what she's saying. I'm staring at Philip Seymour Hoffman the whole time.
Of course.
Because he's standing there and he's like, and when she says that, he goes, ah, what a sense of humor she has. Ah. He's all nervous, like, as if the dude's going to go sue somebody.
Well, that was the thing about him. They, like, he played awkward so well.
Yeah.
Like in the 25th hour with Ed Norton, like being the teacher with the hot student, and he doesn't know, like, my buddy's going to prison for fuck who knows how long.
Mm-hmm.
He just played awkward really well. I mean, Twister was the only movie that I've ever seen him in that he was just like,
awkward.
What's up?
But you know, awkward still. I mean, he was still
like, maybe.
I'm the dorky, awkward, silly, funny guy.
And he also played the Goo Goo Dolls when they drove up to the final scene, which was awesome. Long way down.
Like he's in that music video?
No. Well, yeah, I bet he was. Yeah, in the music video.
What?
Yeah. But no, the...
What are you laughing at?
My squeaky chair. Sorry. I mean, I didn't mean to break the mood.
All right. Anyway, Philip Seymour Hoffman, God bless you. Rest in peace. Welcome to the William Barron Show. This particular part of the podcast is brought to you by Excuse Yourself Koozies, EXKOOZ, Yourself Koozies. Craig, welcome back.
Thank you.
You have not been a privy to the Excuse Yourself Koozies.
I am not.
We finally got one in your hands.
What do you think?
It's lovely.
It's phenomenal.
Lovely.
It's very nice. It's amazing. It is amazing.
No, hang on. No, don't blow smoke up our ass.
I'm not blowing smoke up your ass.
Okay.
Did you look at the bottom?
I did see the bottom.
Yeah.
Now, you know logo. I'm a koozie fan.
Studio.
I love koozies.
Mm-hmm. I know you love koozies.
So I was a big supporter when they came on board.
Mm-hmm.
And here's the thing, like we got 30 of them, and
they're gone. These are the last two, Craig.
Like anybody who asks for a koozie, like if you even bring up a koozie, they're like, "Oh, I want one of those."
Mm-hmm.
It's a fucking koozie.
Everybody
it keeps my beer
koozie.
Cold.
Well, that's the whole
Fuck
thing.
Yeah.
That why wouldn't you promote yourself on a koozie?
Right.
You've got to put your brand on a koozie.
Yeah.
They're gonna go everywhere. Everybody has one, mm-hmm. and they don't throw them away. You keep them.
Right. And these are washable. You can throw them in the wash.
What?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Look, it won't come off.
Have we brought that up yet?
They don't have that. Like you can't scratch it off.
It's sublimation.
You really can throw it in the washing machine?
Yeah.
What?
You can wash it.
You can wash it too.
I'm gonna try it.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Okay.
Love it.
Well, this
you
podcast.
There's the rest of the panel, or just Craig?
Brought to you by Excuse Yourself Koozies. You can find them on Facebook. You can find them on the William Barron Show Facebook page. Danielle, welcome back to the podcast.
Ah, thank you. There it is.
Craig.
There it is.
Welcome back.
When you
agree.
Triple welcome back.
To a sin cleansing confession.
What?
God.
Is this from doubt?
3 weeks.
You got a colonoscopy?
Puberty took a while to get through. August 19th once.
Ew.
August 20th twice.
What?
August 21st.
Move on. You had
three times.
Hey,
I was a machine in the 90s.
It snowed a lot. That's all.
It wasn't called a snow day back then, but
it's called a blow day.
Craig's room looked like a snow globe, one of those snow globes you shake.
Ew.
You guys have a conversation about that, I think maybe like 2 weeks ago or something like that.
About what?
Where you have like a confession where you have to like confess all your sins, but all at once, and you have to like...
Are you talking about Catholicism?
Yes.
We did talk about that.
We did.
Yeah, I just finished up 20 minutes ago.
Oh.
Damn.
You don't feel any particular sin.
Not anymore.
No.
Not now.
I'm empty.
Repented.
I'm dehydrated now.
Oh, gross.
I can't
drink
my
beverage
the ring.
From my
Excuse me. If you're going to promote it, you got to say it right.
Excuse me.
Don't worry. You'll get there. You know, you got to get back on the horse.
I'm not the pitch man. I'm not the pitch man.
You're rusty.
I'm rusty. I haven't been here in, well, this will be third week.
Yeah.
All right. Well, all right. We're going to pitch. Anyway, hashtag Ask Bradley. If anybody has any comments or thoughts or opinions, hit us up on Twitter or Facebook. They do the hashtag thing now.
You didn't introduce Joe yet.
Oh, Joseph, welcome back.
Hi, Joe.
Hi. Thanks.
All right. So speaking of awesome actors. Mm-hmm. Me and Danielle, we watched a movie the other day called Limitless. Have you guys heard of this?
You've seen it.
You've seen the movie.
I think. That's
Greg?
This is the one that has Bradley Cooper in it?
Yeah, with Robert De Niro. He takes a pill.
I saw it. I've seen it. Yep.
It was on TV.
It was an unbelievable film. Like, we didn't get to see the end of it because our DVR didn't record like 3 minutes past the time. So it stopped. And we didn't get to see like the last 3 minutes, but I can't imagine.
So your viewing was very limited.
Yes.
Of this movie.
It was definitely not limitless.
Anybody want to tell us the ending, if you remember?
Didn't see it.
I think he...
How'd you know who was in it?
I can't remember.
Never saw it? You just happened
to remember?
He saw
a commercial?
I know a lot of useless information.
Okie doke. Alrighty.
Welcome to the William Barron Show, where you come to hear about movies that are
we have not
so old, I can't remember how they ended.
Well, regardless.
It was on FX. It's true.
Okay.
It has to be sort of old.
It got me. Well, it's like a year old. I mean, it's not old.
No, it's
think.
Pretty
it's
old.
Older than that.
No. 3-4 years old.
Yeah. What?
Yeah.
I believe
I just saw a commercial for that.
Bradley Cooper wasn't Bradley Cooper when he did that movie. Like, he had just gotten Hangover done. And then his train
all
was
of a sudden
just
he was
roll.
In like every single
this
film.
This was like his next thing after Hangover. Hangover is like 5 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Six.
Okay. All right. Well, yeah, I'll agree with that. But Limitless, I remember seeing a commercial for it.
They came
like,
the A-Team. And
oh, God.
2011.
Mm-hmm. 3 years old.
3 years old.
There we have it.
Okay.
Okay.
I thought it was good. I mean, I liked it.
Well, it got me thinking
about. I want to fucking take a pill to make me smart.
It got me thinking
but
about.
I don't want to die from it.
Yeah, that's the downside.
Yeah.
To drugs, really. at all.
It seemed like a pretty tired premise, though. Like,
yeah.
Take a drug, you become super. And this
right.
one just happened to be he could think and.
Yeah.
And finish his book.
Now
in
the
like
government
3 hours.
Wants you dead or something.
Well, it got me thinking about, like, I mean, especially with the passing of Philip Seymour Hoffman, like, Bradley Cooper is somebody that I really do appreciate as an actor. I mean, am I the only one?
No, I agree with that completely. I'm just shocked to hear you say it.
Why?
Because he's pretty.
Yeah. He's too attractive. You'd be jealous.
It's like you're found love for Ryan Reynolds also. Like, once we watched that box movie where he was in a fucking coffin the whole time and you were like, fucking
buried?
Ryan Reynolds is his shit. I was like, fuck yes.
Wait a minute. Whoa.
Awesome. Glad you agree.
Well, I mean, I'm so happy for you now that we can watch Ryan Reynolds movies. And
Bradley
we can...
Cooper movies.
Holy shit.
Fucking
okay, so that's really...
My life is great.
That's your thought process on...
They're pretty men.
They are very good-looking men. I have no problem admitting that.
And
I have had no problem admitting
is
that.
Is actually there. It's not like Channing Tatum. Like, I'm not asking you to watch fucking Channing Tatum movies.
It's not like Philip Seymour Hoffman. Where
where he's got talent.
He's not
pretty. Maybe not the... He is a pretty guy. I mean, he's got great hair. He's got an awesome beard.
Awesome beard.
Awesome
he's
beard.
Ugly.
Multicolored beard.
He's not very pretty.
I mean,
he's a beautiful.
Awesome actor.
Yes.
Not going to take that away
awesome
from
actor.
Him.
I think he's a good looking
hilarious.
Guy.
Hilarious.
But
yeah.
he didn't get anywhere on his looks. He got it whole.
Yeah,
he only
talent.
Got there on his chops.
Okay.
Talent.
Okay. Well, like we were saying, like with Bradley Cooper, like he has the look and the acting chops.
Yeah.
I don't know if I'm ready to put him on like a Philip Seymour Hoffman level, but.
Right.
No, because he didn't earn it.
Right.
He coasted through. I mean, you know how many modeling, acting gigs he could have gotten.
Right.
That were just paved the way.
Like watch.
Hoffman
watches.
Had to. He had to bust his ass.
That's mm-hmm. true.
He had to
dedicate
put his
himself
nose
to the
grind.
The
do those plays. Do those
yep.
shitty dinner theaters probably coming up and.
Yeah.
It just
dinner theater. You want another roll? No, I mean literally. You want a piece of bread?
Dinner roll.
No. I mean, would you like me to play another roll? One of these days, I'm gonna be too good for this shit.
God bless you, Philip. We are going to take a break. Thank you for listening to the William Barron Show. We'll be right back after this. This is the free download from iTunes. Every day they give away a free download. Did you know that?
Who is this?
I don't know.
No.
I just downloaded it and I liked it. I listened to it and I was like, that's pretty cool.
Is that a podcast you subscribe to?
No, it's just iTunes.
You have to go
just iTunes.
Get
you
it.
Go to iTunes and then you go to the free
one. But it's
one.
Not, you can't.
So
it's
just
not
automatically
RSS feed,
download? No. No. No, you have to go there. You have to go to iTunes.com or whatever. It's kind of cool.
They don't advertise it.
They don't, but they should. I mean, it's kind of like U2. They had that free giveaway for 24 hours during the Super Bowl.
YouTube did?
No, U2.
Oh, U2.
U2 with Bono.
At first, I thought you said U2 at first, and I thought you were talking about me and Craig, because you're looking right at us.
U2.
The two of you.
It's like, you know, when U2, and like, I don't remember.
What were you giving away? What were you giving away for free?
Craig and I don't give anything away.
No, you had a product.
But yeah, they every day they give away something for free, so I'm going to get on top of that.
Every day?
Every day. New song, new band, I mean...
Oh, you're going to fill up that hard drive
fun.
Fast.
Fuck yeah.
That's kind of fun.
Free.
That's almost awesome. 400 songs a year.
Honey, I'm going to buy a new hard drive for my free stuff.
That's almost 400 songs a year.
Not quite.
No, I know.
Close.
I'm aware.
Well, what about holidays?
Yeah, what do they do that last, you know, 365 and a third? Do you get, like, 1 minute of a Christina Aguilera song?
What do you mean a third? Are you talking, like, scientifically how the world
like on
the goes around the sun?
Yeah, 365 and a third, right?
Year?
Or is it a fourth?
That's what leap year does. Yeah, leap year takes care of that.
Yeah, leap year. Yes. And a third. I don't... Well, anyway.
On the fourth year, you get a full day.
Because the Egyptians must have gotten it wrong. That's all I'm saying.
With all their technology, they probably did. Welcome back to the William Barron Show. Danielle, thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Craig?
Still here.
Joseph?
Glad to be here.
This segment is brought to you by BikiniBowFishing.com.
Oh, shit.
Check them out. Go to their website. Pretty ladies that like to hunt fish with a bow.
With a bow. Didn't even know that was possible.
I didn't either. When I saw her shoot it, like I was like, all right, and like, okay, so you shot it.
Like,
what
it
the
sounds really hard.
She's standing in the water in a bikini.
She's in the water?
And she's like standing like probably,
it's
I don't
in
know,
Florida, so they're like
thigh high
where,
in the
you
water.
Know, where they got those Everglades and the water's...
Sure. Alligators, snakes,
and these aren't
hovercraft.
Wolf,
not hovercraft.
When you look at the website,
badass bitches.
These girls are like standing there with their bows, and you're like, at first you're like, oh, they just they paid some models to stand there with bows.
Yeah,
then you watch the video, like, oh shit, these girls really hunt.
Yeah,
these girls get in the water and they shoot it.
Yeah,
and
in bikinis.
In bikinis,
like naked, pretty much.
And then you can reel it in just like a fishing line.
What?
Yeah, you can reel it in through your bow.
You never heard of bow fishing?
It's on the bow, but yeah.
So. You know how, like, in the...
It's pretty incredible.
Okay, so I really didn't watch the video.
You like the lagoon days. Where, you know, maybe they spear chuck a fish.
Yeah, I've seen that shit. Well, or, like, the catching of them on that one stupid show I watched.
Imagine, you know, as humans evolve in technology, now you can tie a rope to that arrow and shoot it.
And then reel it in somehow?
Pull it in, yeah.
They reel it in? Like, there's a reel on their bow.
Yep.
Right. What? But it's not... Yeah, they didn't... Well, they shot it, but it's not a crossbow. It's a, you know, it's an actual, you know, they're actually pulling back the string
the torque,
and they're
right.
Like,
right.
The torque can't be that.
They're using compound bows.
Oh, sure it is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have you ever pulled a bow back?
It's hard.
There was
hard
a
as
well.
Fuck.
I mean, the way they make them now, they make them easier.
Ugh. They're compound bows. They're not like they're not like a long bow.
It's not like Pocahontas days, honey.
Well, no, I've shot and like I've shot a bow before, shot and. Shut
I
up.
Shot in my pants over.
Shut up. No, I have shot a bow before, and it's hard as fuck to pull it back. Like,
no, these ladies kill it.
Well, they make it look easy.
Wow.
And sexy.
They killed one of their photos was a stingray.
Ooh.
That the body of the stingray had to have been twice the size of this table.
Oh
twice
my
the size.
God.
I mean,
are they
it
in the
took.
Ocean?
No, they're just
they're
out in
Florida.
Out in Florida.
So yeah,
just in
the
Everglades.
You got the Gulf. You got the.
Yeah, I don't. I guess I don't know exactly where they killed the stingray.
Sure.
But anyway, they make DVDs. They make calendars. The calendar, actually, if you were to go to BikiniBowFishing.com, buy a calendar, enter to win a entire bow fishing trip with the model of your choice. If you know, with scheduling and everything, if she's available, you're available, then you guys get to go on an entire day of boat fishing, and she's going to teach you how to fucking do the shit. So check them out, BikiniBowFishing.com.
Are we allowed to talk about
real girls looking
together?
Real good, shooting
real
fish.
Yeah, that one's it.
I like it.
What?
I'm intrigued.
So, yeah, check them out. Speaking of the Super Bowl, the Uber fact of the week, did you know? Well, I know. We were talking
Let's find out if I know. Let's play this game.
Speaking of the Super Bowl.
Yeah, but okay. The Uber fact of the week, the Super Bowl, the losing team gets rings.
What?
What kind of ring?
A world or a Super Bowl
good,
ring.
Good for you.
The
ring?
Same? No, not a good for you ring. The same ring.
Nice try.
The same ring that the winners get. What? You get a ring.
But it's like a silver ring instead of a gold ring.
No, it's the same thing.
It's the what same would
you
do?
But you don't get. But it doesn't say world champions on it. It doesn't say champions.
Well, no, but okay. All right,
be
so
like
I guess
Super Bowl it.
It probably just says champion. Super Bowl 3.
Maybe.
Congratulations for getting here. Yeah.
Maybe it says AFC champions. Maybe.
Yeah. That. Yeah, so the losers of the Super Bowl get a Super Bowl ring.
Huh.
You know what?
I'd be very interested to see if it calls
you
a loser.
Just like Little League, everybody gets a trophy.
Oh, it is.
Second Uber fact of the day.
Good job, boys.
Was that they find
here's your loser ring.
Half of those rings on the floor of the locker room when they clean up afterwards.
And the other half? On Pawn Stars.
Yes.
Get rid of this piece of shit. I don't want this.
A constant reminder of how I fell short.
Dude, if I ever saw a football team fall short, that would have to be the Denver Broncos. What did you guys do for the Super Bowl? I know what she did. I was with her. What did you guys do?
Just hung out at home.
Just hung out at home, watch the game?
Yep.
How long did it take you for you to turn it off or go do something more productive with your time?
I was more into
the
commercials from the get-go, but the commercials this year kind of sucked too.
They weren't that great.
See, it was too loud where I was watching it, so I didn't even get to see any commercials. Were there any good ones? I heard about the... No, we were over at our brother-in-law's, and we were just...
It was too loud?
Yeah, I mean, there
was
like eight
talking.
Kids, fucking
so
people talking, eating, conversation.
So many kids.
My wife kept talking to me.
Yeah, right.
No, she was.
I don't do that.
She was great. She poured me Jager bombs the whole time.
That.
It was great.
I was his bartender.
Yep.
Really?
It was sweet. Aww. But so, yeah, we didn't get to listen to any of the Super Bowl commercials. I saw a couple. I heard about the Seinfeld one.
But then Bill got really
the reunion?
Drunk.
Like, how did it go?
Bill got way too drunk.
Well, it was just a promotion for the Seinfeld show that he has on Crackle.
Okay.
And
whoa, what?
Jerry Seinfeld has a webisode show.
Webisode show.
So it's only on the web, on crackle.com.
Crackle. What the fuck is Crackle?
It's a streaming
site. It's like YouTube, except it's...
It's like Netflix, only with commercials or Hulu.
All right.
So, but they have like movies and they have their own TV shows.
You have to subscribe to it?
No. Well, I mean, you sign in, but yeah, it's free.
Okay. Crackle.
I thought the Seinfeld commercial was for like a possible reunion television show, like that was going to be on TBS.
No, that's the rumor they probably wanted you to think. But
hook, line, and sinker.
Basically, all
Bikini
it was.
BikiniBowFishing.com.
They, Jerry and George, and he's playing George, so he is really George Costanza.
Jerry.
No.
George.
Oh, my.
What?
Oh my
God.
Sorry.
What is going on here?
Jerry and George are on the commercial.
Jerry and George are together.
Got it.
The actor that plays George. Yeah. Help me out. I'm forgetting his
name.
Jason Alexander.
I'm fine with George.
Jason Alexander is actually playing George. He's not being Jason. Whereas Seinfeld's show is he interviews comedians while they get coffee.
Okay.
And they just sit there and chit-chat, and they talk and hang out.
Where? Like at a coffee shop?
At a coffee shop.
Okay.
So the whole premise is he picks them up in a car, and he rents a car or finds one that he thinks fits their personality.
What?
So, like, he may show up.
You got all this from a commercial?
No, I've watched the show.
Oh.
So he shows up and picks people up. They drive. They get coffee. They talk. It's
Whoa.
Over.
All
right.
So instead of Jason Alexander being himself, he's playing George Costanza.
Got it.
And Jerry is playing the Jerry Seinfeld Jerry.
Mm-hmm. They're both
from
annoying.
The show. And so they sit there at the coffee shop and they hang out and talk. And then Newman shows up, which was in the commercial.
Mm.
Basically, it's just a shortened version of the episode that
okay.
they did.
And then at the end of it, they tagged the website or whatever?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, that was it.
So any other good commercials? Because
it was actually my favorite commercial.
Oh Jesus! Because you're a Crackle fan.
A Crackle fan. Yeah, I love
Crackle.
Crackle.
I like my Crackle.
Nothing really occurs to me right now.
The only thing that's bothering me about all of it is all the hoopla, internet bullshit is everything's been getting for that one Coca-Cola commercial.
I didn't even see that when I missed that one.
No, which, I did see it. I made some comments when I watched
it.
I didn't see it.
Everybody's giving Coca-Cola a bunch of grief for...
Just because it had a gay set of parents?
It had like 1,000 different ethnicities singing our... America's Beautiful
It had them singing our national anthem. Or no, it had...
America the Beautiful.
Yeah. They had them singing that, but in their native language.
Right.
Because they're...
Oh, God forbid.
Because they're foreigners. Right.
Yeah, so it was like, I don't know, 15 different ethnicities. As well as, yes, gay people, whatever, I mean, singing.
Speaking in their language.
No.
God bless America.
It was definitely flamboyant. And
I don't know why I just sang like Dennis DeYoung, but hey, if the shoe fits, Dennis.
Whatever. Yeah, no, I don't understand the issue with that. That is America. America is ethnicity.
Aren't we supposed to be more...
We're ethnic. That is what we are.
More accepting.
We accept everyone. You can get fucking...
What has this been blowing up your Facebook feed or something?
No, I just didn't with all this reach it.
You know why America
other than
mad.
Facebook, William?
What? I can read, honey.
I do read other than
America
Facebook.
Doesn't like change. America.
It's not change. That is what America is.
It's different.
That's my argument.
Americans
is that
don't like that.
No, I am an American, and I have no problem with it because to me that is what America is. America is accepting,
right.
And we
but the people writing
allow
on
everyone
this,
to become an American.
On
it
this
ain't
hate
that
bandwagon.
Hard. It is not that hard to
that's
become
not
American.
The that's the America you want to live in. That's not the America you live in.
It is the America that my brain lives in.
Well, your brain.
My brain and my heart accepts everybody.
The difference is there's a lot of prejudice out there, and
get over it.
Our country has that.
That's stupid.
I think every country has it.
It's super stupid.
Some people lose their arm for
stealing
like a fucking
with the
orange.
Whole, well, the whole, that whole eastern part of the hemisphere with the gay stuff.
Yeah.
They are like, they.
Yeah, they're pissed. Yeah.
But they're the ones that invented it. Those Europeans. What? What the fuck?
It's not
Caligula?
It's not,
yeah, it's not.
Hello?
I don't agree.
It's not really,
I don't agree.
Is it really European so much? We're just talking like deep east.
It's
like,
not invented, in my opinion.
Anything on the other side of the Atlantic Ocean, as far as I'm concerned, is gay. They all were together. Their land was tied together. They could get around. Right?
Everything was very close. Everything was very close.
I mean, yeah.
I
New Zealand,
don't agree with it being invented.
Fine.
You really think it's an invented?
You
got to
take a 15-hour flight.
What, gay?
Yeah.
No, what I'm saying... No, I was joking, but...
Oh, okay.
What I'm saying
I'm
is...
I'm just checking. I'm checking. Because I don't think it's
they
invented.
Started the world. I mean, civilization started over there.
God started the world, Joe.
So,
Adam and Eve, not Adam.
There was a debate about it.
God.
There was a debate about it.
Don't ever say that on this podcast. Because that's ridiculous.
I know. It is.
It makes me want to stab somebody for saying that. Not that I'm going to stab you.
Adam and Steve?
Adam and Eve, not Adam and Steve.
That shit is the dumbest shit I've ever heard in my
God
entire
life.
God
hates those people. I saw a sign that said so.
Yeah, yeah.
What the
fuck? Somebody standing out in the fucking frigid
cold. Yeah, there was a guy standing out in front of the abortion clinic said so.
Well,
yeah.
Those people are ignorant as fuck.
Right, because he's standing in front of an abortion clinic.
Actually, right outside
God hates fag sign.
Exactly. Yes.
That guy's stupid.
That guy's really dumb.
Yeah,
I think he came to the wrong rally.
Actually, I think he's outside the studio right now.
Actually. Yeah.
What's he doing outside of a recording studio? Like,
God hates fag.
You know what?
Then, I hate you, Craig.
Now that is
dude,
one.
Dude, quit following me around.
Follows him everywhere.
He's at work tomorrow.
Grocery store.
Craig!
No, that is one part of our audience that I wouldn't mind alienating. That
what?
if you're that ignorant that you hate
homophobes.
People for the choice. Yeah.
Oh,
I mean,
okay.
or any prejudice
right.
whatsoever.
Yeah.
Get
the
go fuck
yourself. Over it and
Did
shut
you hear
up.
That?
Shut the fuck up and get over it.
That was the sound of half of our listeners
turning us around. We are going to take a break.
That's a sound like you're
no
opening a bottle.
Well, makes sense.
And we are going to
drink a bottle.
We're going to take a break. We will be right back. Thank you for listening to the William Barron Show.
Try this again on Wednesday, then recheck our reaction. I'm sorry for anything that I said, getting too deep inside my head. Let's start this over. it's so unnerving that we're that quick to run. Yet the memories come, didn't mean to pin them on you. You're so deserving of time and space to learn. Yet the second chance against all the odds, against me. Up for a Monday and a Tuesday. Right.
There ain't none of that.
I'm sorry, Marquette.
Welcome back to the William Barron Show. This segment is brought to you by Sarah Schonert, music.com. Sarah with an H, S-C-H-O-N-E-R-T. That was her song that you just listened to. Check her out on iTunes. Find her on Google. Find her on Facebook. She's everywhere.
Hey, girl, hey.
So before we got off on a tangent about, I don't know, Coca-Cola. Was there? No, that wasn't a tangent. No. That was a respectful sure. Memorandum.
It might have been a tangent. Whatever. I felt like I went.
This show is tangents. This show is primarily tangents.
That's kind of what we do, honey.
Okay.
I was on a tangent. I think. Anyway.
About what? What were you on a tangent?
That I think it's ridiculous that they're getting backlash for it because it was a beautiful commercial.
Okay.
You thought it was beautiful?
It was beautiful.
Like tearful? Like man.
No, I'm not a crier. That didn't happen.
Yeah.
But it was pretty.
Okay.
There ain't no reason to be mad about it. That's for fucking sure.
Yeah. It's a fucking commercial for Coca-Cola.
There ain't no goddamn
reason
to be mad about it. Anybody. My opinion.
Joe, what did you do for the Super Bowl?
Well.
I have to imagine
after
that.
I saw that commercial, I turned off my TV.
Cried a little bit.
Made yourself a poster boy that used to hang on that door back
picked
there?
Picked up my shot. Oh. Picked up my gun and I bared arms because it's my given right.
Touche.
Actually, I went to a friend's house, watched the game. His girlfriend, my wife, some other people came over related to his girlfriend, like all of her sisters. And and so it was a group of us. And
a family affair?
Yeah, and it was a good time, but
good.
Drinks were flowing.
Yeah.
And it got to the point where the game was so bad.
Oh, yes. God, it was awful.
I'm not even paying attention that much. Yes. Now I find myself in the kitchen having a 20-minute discussion with someone.
With the women?
No. It was with my buddy. The women were all keeping each other company.
They're usually in the kitchen.
And 20 minutes goes by, and I'm like...
Not, I'm just saying.
Chauvinistic.
I'm not even watching the game.
From the lady.
Sorry.
Get those bitches in the kitchen.
But that halftime show was phenomenal.
It was
I loved
it. Bill ruined it for me.
I thought it was great.
I'm just gonna go ahead.
Why
and
you're not
Bill
a Bruno Mars fan?
No, he's not.
What? How did I ruin it?
You were first of all drunk as shit.
Yeah.
Well, whose fault was that, bartender?
Yeah, right.
Yes. Bomb gal.
Well, because he wasn't necessarily excited about being there, so I wanted to make it a little funner for him. So I decided to get him super drunk by pouring him.
Now we all know
like
that line.
10 minutes,
Mr. Barron's.
I do have a
yeah.
You want to show Bill Barron a good
he knew
time.
He knew he wasn't driving. I knew he wasn't driving.
If
and
you
so
want to show Bill Barron a good time, GMC, get him drunk
all
in
right
a truck.
You missed this silliness they started.
I don't know if he missed
so anyway,
it.
So how did
well,
I...
Well, he wasn't here for
how
it
did I ruin this? The Bruno Mars Chili Peppers?
Because I was sitting next to you and your drunk ass, and you were like, he's not singing any of that. This is all dubbed over. This is not real. He's not playing that. They're not doing this. They're not doing this. They're not doing that. This is fake.
I'm sorry. I have a little bit of
like
problem
all
with that.
In my ear. And finally, I was just like,
so
you
that
know what?
Drum
I need
solo
you to shut
was
the
fake
fuck up right now.
No, I mean, it was all pre-recorded. Am I wrong?
The
I
drums?
Mean, no, like even Flea.
Oh, he said all of
like
it.
The
all
only.
No,
oh,
he admitted the only
fake
thing was new. The only thing that
was
live
real
was the vocals.
Was the vocals.
Yeah.
So the drums were
he,
air
Bill
drums.
Was not even saying that.
The worst part of the Chili Peppers. Have that be live.
Yeah.
Wait a minute, what?
He doesn't even, he barely remembers the Chili Peppers.
Have the worst part of the Red Hot Chili Peppers be the live part.
Now hang on. You say it's the worst part, but it's still pretty strong.
It was all good in my opinion. I loved every bit of it.
They got a great guitar, or a great bass player.
I didn't understand
solid
why
drummer
the Chili Peppers interrupted Bruno Mars, because that, to me, was what that was.
Well, Bruno, how Bruno Mars asked him to.
How would you feel if you knew that Bruno Mars was told he could pick anyone he wanted?
There ain't no fucking way he picked them.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, he did.
He did.
He did.
He was told he could have one guest, and he asked the Chili Peppers personally.
Seriously?
To be there. Yes.
Mm-hmm. No way.
Yes.
Yeah.
Why?
Because it was awesome to pick them.
All right. I mean,
I enjoyed it. I'm not saying I didn't enjoy it.
I enjoyed it,
really?
Too. It did bother me that a band like the Red Hot Chili Peppers would go on stage. And I read Flea's apology on some website.
I appreciate that he's forthcoming with that. I mean, but it's common practice.
What's that?
Flea, the bass player for the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
He apologized because they
didn't have any chords sticking to their guitars. Oh. So they were air guitaring
the
whole time.
You were telling me that.
You know
too,
what I like, though, is how... Because you know they were told, well, here's your wireless thing. Plug it in.
Right.
No. If we're unplugged.
Right. I thought his apology was completely legit.
I apologize for not actually playing on the show tonight.
No, he said that, Craig, you could probably sum it up better than I can.
Well, he was just being forthright as far as, like, you know, we weren't plugged in. I mean, the vocals were live, but, you know, we like to thank...
We're not trying to fool anybody.
Right. And there's a common practice as far as being pre-recorded. I mean,
right. And the Super Bowl, yeah.
Super Bowl is this way.
Yeah, no, I know. Because
it's a show, and they want to put on the show, which means if you're dancing, you're probably not singing at the same strength
Why I think it's stupid to even do it.
I wouldn't
call
them.
Yes, I will agree with
that.
But the whole
they were jumping. They jumped a lot.
The whole reason that the Super Bowl has to set everything up quick is because they only have a certain amount of time,
right.
And to go in and sound check and have everybody tune up
and
have everything.
Venue with
there's
those fucking people.
Watch the video of it, and it's like only 14 minutes long,
right?
And that's with a little bit of lead time into it.
Sure.
I mean, there's no way you can do that.
Right? No, I get all.
But
that.
I'm with Joe also being like, just fuck that. Go to Al and Jim and the fucking thing, and let's watch replays or something.
If you want to have a show like that, be like. Include the world in this, okay? The halftime show.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the people in the stands, fuck them. They want to go get a piss, get a beer, whatever they need to do.
Mm-hmm.
They don't need a halftime show.
Right.
Why don't they say, okay, and now for your Super Bowl halftime live show, we're going to kick it over to Los Angeles with Bruno Mars.
Yeah.
And he's there in a club.
Genuinely live.
Jamming.
Right.
Right.
And
why
does
it have to be on the fucking
field?
And
then the guest comes out and they're... Cord it all
jamming
up.
Jamming too, yeah.
Rocket.
It's all live.
We're trying to justify the $350 ticket price.
Yeah.
Yeah.
$350. Where are you buying that?
Whatever it is.
The cheapest ticket was like $1,000.
There you go.
Rub.
And that, what you got for that? Bruno Mars.
Yeah.
And actually Peppers.
Yeah.
Lip syncing.
A girlfriend and I tried to get tickets to, I didn't tell you this because it didn't happen, but tickets to the Bruno Mars show that was up. That's supposed to be up in near Chicago this summer.
Yeah.
Sold out in like 10 minutes.
Well, the guy's got talent.
Oh, he does have talent, but you know why it sold out so quick?
Tenley Park? Fucking Tenley Park, you sold out in 10 minutes?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
You know when those big shows go on sale and it pisses me off, which is why I don't go to the big shows anymore.
Because
they're already sold out by the time they go on fucking sale.
Yeah,
right.
Pretty much. That was what
happened. Because you had the people who only have American Express cards,
hey.
And then they already bought those tickets. And then
pre-orders.
And pre-orders and stuff like that. And the people who had the fan club members hopefully got good seats.
Well, they could also buy up to 10 tickets, and then you find out that those 10 tickets are on StubHub.
Yeah.
Or eBay or whatever.
Yeah.
It is.
And I'm never.
And that just pisses me off.
I'm never paying triple price for something. Mm-mm.
I'm not gonna argue that.
No, I'm not gonna do
as
that.
As much as I would, if someone said, "Hey, we're gonna go see Bruno Mars," I'd be like, "Fucking hey, we're gonna go see Bruno Mars." I would totally go see him.
I was too.
I would
like
never.
$50, I'd do it.
But I'm not, gonna,
no,
but I'm not necessarily
gonna
pay
price.
$150
why,
for it either.
Why would you want to go to
I'm
that show?
No, I don't. I did.
Why?
Because he's awesome.
He's awesome, and you're gonna sit there and watch him on a fucking big screen.
Jumbotron, exactly.
That
well, that's
sucks.
Not what I was picturing when she introduced
well,
the
you're
idea.
Seeing,
I was like, fuck
you're
yes.
seeing the, but you're also seeing the stage performance too, as far
I'm
as like the spectacle of it
on TV.
Middle upper bowl.
Well, would you go see U2?
No,
you would go see U2
as big what? As their as their shows get, and how they can justify
you know why
$150
because
you see $150
because the seat I
you.
Can afford, right. I am literally hearing an echo.
Yeah.
He's singing something.
He just sang that yesterday.
Exactly.
That's sound check. Why am I hearing sound check way back here?
I'm hearing. He's going.
Testies.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Testies.
The Edge. When the Edge isn't even on the stage because there's a drum solo going on.
Yeah.
When did this happen?
All right.
You two plays a drum solo.
Yeah.
No.
It would consist of.
That's how bad my seats are. I'm sitting next to the guy. The one guy in the band, no one knows his name. Same haircut, 1985.
You're the drummer. Too cute to be in this band. Hey, Joe.
Way too young.
What if I told you you could see U2 for only $30 and you get to go backstage and meet a member of the band? Sign me up. And that was my gift. I get to go meet the drummer.
For $30, yeah, I'm in.
Yeah, I'm doing it.
Yeah.
$30? That's not
30 bucks? Fuck yeah.
You're going to park? You go through all the $10 beer?
That's a $120 discount.
Right.
Fuck yeah, man.
Screw that. I wouldn't ever go to... Guns N' Roses is my favorite band of all time. If they got back together, that's exactly what would happen, and right. I wouldn't go.
Zeppelin.
No.
You wouldn't go?
I can't. I can't put myself through
you can't justify.
The dissatisfaction of sitting in that back row going, this sucks.
So don't be a tightwad and spend the extra money.
I'm not going
to
risk
it.
No, because then he's in the front row like, this ain't $350.
No. I can't leave my seat. I just drank 10 beers. I got to watch the show.
I got to watch the show.
And I got to pee the
whole
time.
What?
I'm gonna piss on the security guard real quietly.
That's why I like when these bands like right now, it's so hard to make money as a musician. You can't sell records anymore. It's all about touring.
Yeah.
These guys tour.
I think it's always been that way, though.
No. They used to have
Sarah.
They used to be able
get
to
the
sit.
Van, Sarah.
Yeah, Sarah.
They used to be able to sit on their laurels. They used to be able to make a record, tour it, and then sit back and let some cash roll in. Now, as soon as they get home, they're like,
"We gotta make a new album.
We gotta make some more cash."
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yes.
iTunes is.
No.
No.
Certainly
no.
helped
nope.
the record
nope.
industry.
No.
Nope.
It has really? Helped iTunes.
Up against Napster, you don't think that iTunes saved the music industry?
No.
No.
It at least shut Napster down.
How the fuck?
Oh,
no, yeah, Napster's still there.
Oh.
You just have to pay
Napster
like
got shut down because of the government.
There's just another.
Right.
There's always another one where it'd be line one
so,
or whatever.
So I'm interested. You guys do not believe that iTunes saved the music industry.
No.
In fact, you guys
would
argue
so
that it
hurts. Killed it because now it's about the single, not about the album.
Yeah.
It was always about the single. I call bullshit there. It was
no.
Like,
but
when
you
I
had
was
to buy
up,
the album.
No,
yeah, but
no,
I...
No.
Oh, yeah.
I used to go to
you
fucking
can buy a
whatever
that
shit
sure.
bag.
Yeah. Like a single.
And even back then, they were $4. Now you can buy it for $1.29.
Fuck yeah.
No, they were like $2 or
$3. Yeah.
In the
downloaded
store, you could get like two, three songs
$3.99.
Yeah, and your $16, $17 CD at list price, but now you get it at $9.99 because they're not going to move them
that's
unless
true.
They have that
true. That is true.
Yeah.
An album used
and
to
and the
cost
bands aren't making any more off that. They're making less.
And you can't buy I tried to buy a CD. I go into Best Buy. I couldn't find it.
No,
well,
you won't.
They're down to like two aisles.
Yeah,
yep.
They are.
Yeah.
I would argue that that's an awesome thing.
I'm about ready to go full hipster.
It's awesome for you. It's not awesome for the industry.
I
look
don't know if I agree with
it's
that.
It's awesome for the musician that is in his basement and wants to put some music out and maybe he'll get heard. It is not awesome for the guy that writes. It's not awesome for Lionel Richie who writes a hit song.
Yeah. How much fucking money does Lionel Richie need?
I'm talking about those guys. The guys that are the prolific
some Jerry Curl juice and...
He's making more right now in the interest of the stuff that he made in the 80s
right.
than a guy now.
Yes. Like licensing and stuff.
Right.
Well, because he sold...
Those album sales are gone, and they're gone forever. And then, no, that didn't help the industry.
All right, I'm just going to... All right, we are going to take a break, and I have an argument for this, but...
Let's enjoy Sarah for a moment.
Yeah. Sarah Schoner,
music.com.
Check her out on iTunes, Spotify.
Hey. You think
Google,
if she could,
Facebook.
If she could, if she
oh,
could
yeah.
push,
not LimeWire.
If she could push it into the Best Buy back in the 90s, don't think she would.
Everybody
wanted to do that.
All right.
Absolutely.
We are going to take a break. Thank you for listening to the William Barron Show. We'll be right back after this.
Lovely warning of the storm that's blowing on the edge of today. This person you think you know, far cry from who I am. I'll admit it's partly true. I'm a function of a chain reaction of reconciling. Recognize this for what it is and understand that it will implode. Enjoy the swell that's in your hands, but know that you'll have to let it go. Don't think I didn't love.
Welcome back to the William Barron Show. This segment is brought to you by SarahShonertMusic.com. Sarah with an H. S-C-H-O-N-E-R-T-Music.com. You can check her out on iTunes. Now, talking about iTunes, like, I guess my view on, you know, buying the album, going to the store, going to Best Buy, and having to buy the CD and like, teeth off that little fucking piece of sticker at the top and
the
fucking
like
thing.
And I miss that.
I do not. But here is where I think that iTunes helped the music industry is that it holds the record labels and the artists to a higher standard. It makes you, like, you can go there, spend $1.29 for the hit. You can also go buy the album for the same amount of money that you would have bought it at Best Buy. However, when you used to buy it back in the day, CD-wise, you bought it for that one song, and then you had, like, two or three other good songs, and then you had an album full of just shit.
Yeah.
I mean, how many times did that happen to you guys, where you went out and bought an album, and you were just like, this
damn
second
near
half of the album.
Damn near.
No, I agree with that, too, but at the same time, it's also the back catalog. You're not buying the greatest hit for the greatest hits album. You're buying just the one you want.
Well, I don't see how there's anything wrong with that. Like, I just bought Spice Girls' greatest hits.
Oh, my God. Why would you admit that on here?
This is why he would never sing in a band I'm involved with.
No, I just bought the...
By 999.
I just bought the Spice Girls' greatest hits, and they are missing a lot of hits.
Yeah, Bill.
They are missing a lot of hits. I am not ashamed to say that I like the Spice Girls. I love them. Like, they're great.
Bill was in the Coca-Cola commercial.
I was singing "Spice Up Your Life,"
spinning around.
Hey, whatever.
I'm just way too old to admit that.
When the Spice Girls came out, I was the right age.
The perfect age.
I was. Yes,
no,
I was.
You weren't the right
consumer.
Gender.
You were not the right age or gender. True.
You don't get to put five hot girls into a group and just be like, this is just for girls.
How dare any of you tell anyone what they can or cannot enjoy
thank you.
Musically.
Thank you very much.
No, it's just funnier to say something about it.
It's not weird.
It's so weird.
They had great songwriters.
Bill, it's so weird.
They did. They had great songwriters.
It's not that weird.
It's fucking weird.
It's okay.
See, Joe, do you see what I put up with every day?
Does anybody else feel like Joe is just waiting to knock it out of the park?
I know
it's
he's all not.
Right. It's okay.
It was genuine.
It's all
he was with Bill when they went through this stage.
I hated
when
every
Bill,
minute of it.
When Bill went through this Spice Girl stage, they lived together.
Yeah,
That's how old this man was. And he didn't even live at home.
When to become one.
Joe had to listen to this shit on replay in their home together. He knows how much Bill loves the Spice Girls. Bill didn't live at home.
So who's your Spice Girl?
You're
baby.
So old. You
baby
didn't
is.
Live at
baby.
Home.
Baby
you is.
Who's your Spice Girl, Craig?
Sporty, maybe?
Sporty?
Sporty?
Yeah, sporty.
Was it Sporty or Sports?
Craig,
no,
makes
Sporty.
Me wanna
Sporty Spice.
Make an ugly face.
Was it Sports what? Spice?
She's no,
it
was Sporty.
What?
Yes,
she always wore like Adidas, like
I don't
fly
like
pants,
no scaries, in fact,
tank tops and shit.
So you got babies, sports.
You got baby. Scares. You got baby, sporty, scary, ginger, and posh.
Well, oh, I know all of them. Don't get me wrong, but I'm a bitch, and I was born in '85, so
therefore
it's okay.
You're a scares Spice. Scary? Is that yours?
No.
Yeah, who is your
My
Spice
favorite
Girl.
Was Baby also.
Ooh.
Oh, well,
that's
then.
Why you're married.
But I partook to Ginger, but I always knew she was old.
Who was the best
was
singer of the Spice Girls?
Probably Sporty,
no.
I would say. Yeah.
Sporty had the best.
She
voice.
Was the, what is it, the alto?
I disagree.
Posh was the baritone.
Sporty was not.
Yeah, she was.
I mean, that's. Have you ever heard her talk?
Sporty
yeah, that's exactly
sounded
what
she like
sounds
she
like.
She had an effect on her vocal.
Did
though.
Posh belong in the Spice Girls
they all had
on talent?
On
or was
no.
it looks alone?
It was sheer looks,
yeah, no,
and she was a baritone.
She
that
can't
was it.
Sing.
Victoria.
She could sing.
Congrats
I mean, she hit a baritone.
To David Beckham.
Well,
hang
so
your
she's
head on
like,
that.
Hey, everybody.
When to become one.
Why you gotta be Snuffleupagus?
Hey, bird.
Snuffleupagus.
Why don't we sing a song together, bird?
I mean,
she
if you
talk like that, she doesn't.
If you wanna like legitimately look at the, but it would have to be sporty or scary.
I can't believe we're having this.
It's scary. Right.
Well,
it
I want to figure this out once and for all.
Scary Spice was the best singer. Scary Spice was the best singer.
Yeah, I would say Sporty gave her a run for the money.
She always had an effect on her voice.
She always had the solos.
Yeah, she
with
no
an effect.
No, she did not have an effect.
Yes, she did.
No, she did
a
not.
A soothing effect on
like
Bill's
compression.
Soul?
Yeah, bullshit. Compression maybe,
yes.
But that's about it.
They didn't have auto
compression.
They didn't have auto tune back then.
Well, it sounded like auto tune.
Well, they did.
That's how
good she was.
That's how good she was.
No, stop it. It was no.
So your favorite voice is the yo, I'll tell you what I want.
That's
what
Sporty.
I really, really want.
That's
I'll
Sporty.
Tell you what you want, what you really, really want.
It's Sporty.
Wanna?
No, that's the no. The intro
scary
is
Spice.
Scary.
Oh, that's right.
We're
that's
still
right,
talking
right.
about this
because I remember the video.
Oh, Bill was
where she,
all night
she like
long.
Jumps from the
like,
yo, I'll tell you what I want, what you really want.
Oh my God, your face was so good.
I so want to be on a boat right now.
Greg's
shooting
like, why'd
at fish.
I come
oh, oh,
why'd
you want to talk about
in?
Your Desert Island records?
I want to get your Desert Island record. Spice Girls' greatest hits.
Hey.
If you
Madonna's
could build,
greatest hits.
If you could have an iPod with solar power.
Do you have your iPhone with you right now? I totally ran over you. I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
iPhone?
You have your iPhone with you. Do you have music on your iPhone?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What if we played iPod roulette with you right now?
What does that mean?
iPod roulette.
It means you put it on music.
Okay.
Put it on shuffle.
Shuffle.
And okay. And we play the first five songs that play.
Ooh.
Mm.
All right. I mean, I guess we can do that.
You guys keep that much music on your phone?
Like songs?
I probably got like 3 gigs worth.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know what that means.
I got like 3 songs.
I have like 1,000.
And you're not going to like any of them.
I talk about my dad a lot, but understand some people.
Oh, he has all kinds of stand up.
Oh, does he?
Kevin Hart, where you at?
Kevin Hart. Well, those 15 minutes are about up.
All right.
All right. Dude, Kevin Hart needs to. His publicist needs to be like, Kevin, you got to.
No. His publicist is doing a bang up job. No. Get him out there now. Get him out there now.
His manager needs to be like, rein it in.
Yeah, let's bring it back.
His manager needs to say, rein it in. Publicist is doing a kick ass job.
You're about to make the whole world get sick of you.
I am sick of him. I'm sick of looking at his smiling ass fucking face.
No, I'm not.
I can't handle it. But you haven't gone to see one of his 18 movies that has come out in the last 3 months.
Well, no.
He's everywhere. I mean,
is
like,
he?
Everywhere.
Did you all go see Ride Along?
No.
It was like the number one movie for like 2 weeks.
I know,
there's
Ice Cube.
Movie called Ride Along? Yeah.
It's him and Ice Cube.
Oh,
driving in a car.
Yes.
That's why
I
didn't see it.
Didn't
yeah.
We
did.
We don't go see movies, though. We just
right.
Don't. I mean, I. We don't.
We watched 97 minutes of a 100-minute movie. That's
yes.
What we like to do at the parent
right.
House.
We
fucking DVR.
If we get a night out with no children's, we ain't going to a
to the bar.
Movie. We ain't going to a movie. We're going to a fucking bar.
I'd
we're
rather
drinking and we're talking.
I'm not
going to
spend
no
2 hours.
That's what
in
we do.
Darkness.
We get shit for it. We get shit for it. Like my mom will be like,
yeah.
Don't just go sit at a bar stool all afternoon.
Go sit in a movie seat.
Fuck you, mom.
And get fed
and don't talk to one another.
Fuck you, mom. We happen to enjoy each other's company, so we're not going to a movie. I'm sorry.
No.
Dinner movie.
So
overrated
now you have,
when
so,
you're married.
So,
with kids.
So you're a grown adult and you still have to lie to your mom?
Yes.
Yeah,
when,
I did.
When you come pick up your
yeah,
kids.
I did do that.
So what'd you guys do? Went to a movie.
She's like,
yeah, I'll spray
give
my
some
shit.
Gum.
Like, no smoke on me.
You guys realize.
Yeah, no, I still, at 28 years old, lie to my mom.
That when someone doesn't smoke and you show up spritzing yourself, all you do is smell like an ashtray with perfume spilled.
Yeah, yeah. No, I know. I'm fully aware of it.
Okay.
But for some reason, it makes my subconscious feel better.
Hmm.
It's fine.
So is that what would happen if you went for another 4 hits on that?
Okay. No, yeah.
Maybe.
We'll do that.
Maybe. Maybe it would. He has a lot of stand-up on his shit. Because when he used to work.
When
not
he used to work,
at the studio.
Period.
I was prefacing it with not at the studio.
Whoa. Okay.
Really?
Ooh, I would have never guessed this one.
Next. 2, 3, not gonna expect this either. Your fucking sound effects.
That's the Paul Walker sound effect
sound
right there.
Well, yeah.
Oh. mm-hmm. But my Philip Seymour Hoffman joke is cut out.
He died 2 days ago.
So.
That's what I got. Those are my five.
That's your five?
Those are my five. Right.
Let's hear Craig.
Kevin Hart live.
Right. I have to get mine.
Am I going? All right. I'll go.
Try and play him faster than Bill did. Back in the USSR?
Yep.
Hey, hey. The Beatles.
Robin Trower.
Okay.
If you could hold the phone a little bit closer.
If you could let us all hear that.
What am I doing? Like, put mine on.
Ooh, Led Zeppelin.
More Robin Trower.
You want to hit shuffle.
Hey, mama said the way you move. Ooh, yes. Make you sweat, gonna make you move.
There you go. There's your five.
All right.
He's up.
Here's my three.
Let's see.
He's up.
I just found a new album on there. I didn't realize it was there.
This is such a silly thing to do, but I love it.
Okay. I'm not sure how this works. I never use my phone to play music.
Really? Do you not work out?
Yeah, but I have an iPod.
You
don't use your phone as an iPod?
Well, no, because he's got he's got an iPod.
Yeah, you got on
dedicated
got
music.
On.
All right, here we go.
Okay.
This might be one of those slow songs.
Phone. Sell your iPod and use your phone. Just saying.
Holy shit, talk about play it quicker than Bill.
I know.
It's about time. Thank God.
You guys know this song?
No.
Well, this is just a simple song. No?
Uh-uh.
It's a hit.
No.
All right. The Shins. It didn't play the next
one. My turn.
Do we have any more singers?
Is that Nickelback?
Yeah, buddy.
Oh, I was hoping, like, can we get...
All right, now, next one. Next one.
Yeah, we gotta avoid paying any royalties here.
Just hold it right there. Oh, two Eagles song, back to back. Four Eagle.
Jesus Christ, I don't like you that much. Oh,
Wreck-It Ralph.
Wreck-It Ralph. Did not make you happy.
Somebody has kids.
I do. Two of them.
It was great.
Jesus.
Downloading that album.
Oh, jeez.
Music pretty much didn't get any better after 1999.
Not in the... Baron household.
I love my iPod. Shut the fuck up.
She's sitting here. Fucking, he was so old, like the fucking Spice Girls. But I really love the
Puddle
Eagles.
The Eagles.
Puddle Mud. Yeah, that's
Nickelback.
My shit.
Nickelback, Eagles, Puddle of Mud, and Wreck-It Ralph. Beautiful.
It's my iPod.
Thank you guys for listening to the William Baron Show. This show was brought to you by BikiniBowFishing.com. Check them out. Buy a calendar. Enter to win a private bow fishing extravaganza lesson.
I think
all day
model.
All day
I
lesson.
Do it.
Will you pick your own mile?
I want to do it.
I totally want to do it.
If you can work out your schedule with
if
the model,
yours,
they're busy.
I'm
they're
coming,
busy. So
cuz I want to learn.
Well,
he's not eligible. Looking,
I'm not.
Win.
We're not nobody here is eligible.
What?
We can't win.
I'm out.
Lame.
We're giving away.
But they are actually coming into town to film the bikini girls like shoot the Asian carp.
They're coming to Peoria.
They're coming from Florida.
This
Peoria for that.
They want to
stop by the show.
I would love.
They
to
want
that.
Us to come
they
check
do.
Them
they
out.
They want to stop by the show.
Oh,
they want us to
I'd totally
on the
go.
Movie.
Do some cross promoting and fucking check them out. And
oh yeah.
Everything.
Craig's like, I'm in.
I'm in.
Bitches in bikinis on the.
I'll be in a bikini. You need me to be in a bikini? I'll be in a bikini.
Are you gonna be in a mankini?
Makini. Well, there's the name of the show.
Craig Makini.
Thank you guys for listening to the William Baron Show. Make sure you check everybody out. And welcome back, Craig.
Thank you. Glad to be back.
Danielle, thank you.
Daniel.
For Daniel.
That's
Danielle,
new.
Thank you for coming.
All right. Thank you.
Joseph.
Always a pleasure.
I'm really sorry that we can't see eye to eye on the iTunes thing.
We'll get there.
We'll work through it.
You're usually a few years behind where I am.
Oh.
I've got the Peoria mentality. I get it. All right. Thank you guys for listening. We will check you guys out next week.
Yeah.